Hey yo, what is poppin' with you do? Carocaro Studio back finally for a new Wi-Fi battle. And if you're wondering why there hasn't been a new Wi-Fi battle in days, like nearly a week and a half now, it's because Camtasia has been crapping out on me. Everyone knows I love Camtasia, I always use Camtasia, but every single time I opened it up, it would just instantly close. So I had no chance to upload a Wi-Fi battle. I couldn't edit a Wi-Fi battle because every single time I tried to edit it, it would just crash on me. And I've had this battle saved up for weeks. Want to upload it, I couldn't do anything about it. If you're following me on Facebook or Twitter, you would know about this, but if you haven't followed me on Facebook or Twitter, I advise that you do, because then you would know about these things and you wouldn't be wondering where the Wi-Fi bells have gone. Either way, also if you look up into the corner, we got our little selves, a little swine up just sniffing all around the corner. He's just sniffing. That's a sniffing sound. Swine up just sitting in the corner. Tell me if you like Swine up there, because if you click on Swine up, it will take you to a link to our channel where if you're half subscribed yet, you can subscribe. So quick click on Swine up after the battle, and you can go straight to our channel and subscribe to Carocaro Studio. Either way, team preview, we got Diggersby, Skarmory, Galvantula, Mega Blastoise coming back at you, the Edelweiss is coming back, Heatran, and our new member of the squad, Slurpuff named Archer. We're facing a guy named Matt, who is Cradily, Terrakion, Volcarona, Hippowdon, Aerodactyl, Hydreigon. This is an OU tier battle, but bring lower tier Pokemon. Bring one OU or two OU at most. I don't think Matt brought any OU Pokemon. I brought the Heatran. So let's see how this battle goes. Like, comment, subscribe. Like goal is 10 likes. You guys haven't been hitting the like goal lately. I have to bring that up too. We have not been hitting the like goal lately. The like goal is 10 likes. You guys are struggling to hit like 8 likes. I'm not going to change the like goal. So we've been getting more subscribers. So there's no reason why you guys cannot get the like goals. All you have to do is... there. You hit the like button. All you have to do is the one little click and the like button is hit. That's all you have to do. It's all I'm going to ask. 10 likes. Either way, like, comment, subscribe. Carocaro Studio. And let's enjoy this Wi-Fi battle together. Let's go. Starting this battle off against Matt. Matt is going to lead off with his Hydreigon, who is a terrifying Pokemon against my Big Nuckle. Because Big Nuckle can do whatever he wants, because he's a Diggersby. But I forgot, misplay, first turn misplay. Hydreigons are always scarfed up nowadays, including my one. He gets a critical hit Surf, and Diggersby goes down in one hit, so Big Nuckle didn't do anything this round. Either way, that leaves a nice opening for Archer, our new Slurpuff to just hop in here. Volcarona comes out, don't know why, because Archer just has to use that belly drum. And half of my HP is gone, but now I got +6 physical attack. Eat that citrus berry, nom nom nom. And now we got some 25% of our HP back, and on burden is activated. So eat his return. Volcarona, bitch! I do get the flame body, that's probably what he wants. He probably only wants the flame body, because Archer would have swept this team without the flame body. So Archer gets burned. So I'm technically at +3 attack right now. Volcarona goes down. Hydreigon comes back out. Don't know why, because Archer's just like, I want them buns. And just gone. Ate Hydreigon. Nom 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 nom. Archer's like a big muffin, but he just ate a nice three-headed dragon for dinner. Just nom 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 nom. Greedy, greedy Archer. Greedy, greedy. Out comes Hippowdon. Should have done this in the beginning, because Hippowdon's obviously the physical wall. Hippowdon can take a burned play rough from +3, so from +6, so you know. He's gonna go for the protect. Not sure why. I guess he's just trying to stall out burn sandstorm damage, but I'm just gonna go for the wish, because you know, why not? Archer stunned his job already. Like, he already took out two Pokemon. He's burned. He's took out two Pokemon. He's burned. Sandstorm's going on. He's not surviving, so I just sent him the wish. So I'm gonna switch out Archer, because you know what? I don't need Archer anymore, really. Send him the Edelweiss, because Blastoise. Who doesn't like the whole red and blue Blastoise? Hippowdon's with Stab Earthquake. Just over half to my Edelweiss. But you know what? That's why I use Wish. Because selfless Archer, just selfless Slurpuff, oh my god, that's a tongue twister. That's a tongue twister. Selfless Slurpuff just used Wish. Gave my Edelweiss half his hate, most of his HP back. The Mega Balloon goes off. Arm Cannons, three cannons, Mega Blastoise, Mega Man coming at you. I knew he's gonna switch out. Switch out was obvious. I was hoping he'd switch out into really anything. So I just went out with the Dark Pulse. I really should have went with the Ice Beam, because half his teams beat the Ice Beam, so. So, yeah, Ice Beam now. I used Ice Beam now when I should have used the last time to get super effective damage. Does a nice chunk of Cradily, but Sandstorm makes it so much more bulky. Then a Miracle comes my way, and the Edelweiss just gets completely demolished by a Cradily with Miracle. I don't know what Cradilies do normally, because they're Cradily. Either way, I send out Heatran. I go with the substitute, so I'm like, what can a Cradily do to me? Can recover? I know they have recover. I know they have access to Seltharox. So I wasn't really worried about any of that, really. worried about the stealth rocks. Wasn't worried about anything else. So I'm just like, you know what, Heatran? Just do your things. You substitute. What can this Cradily do to you? Power Whip? No. Rock Tomb? I don't think so. I'm going to send my own stealth rocks. Just throw the stealth rocks all over the field. Cradily uses Infestation. I don't know why this thing has Infestation, because it uses it on a substituted Fire Steel type Pokemon. It's not going to break the cell. It's not even going to close to breaking this. It'll probably do like 1 to 2 damage. It's not even Stab. Has a power of like 30 probably. I'm just gonna go with the Lavaplume, just hoping for the burn. I don't want to do damage, just want to get the burn for the residual damage. Get the burn, nice and clean burn. Either way, Cradily's gonna go with the recover. As you can see, this is kind of going into a stall war. I'm just stalling out the sand. I just want the sand to go away, because after the sand's gone away, Cradily will not be nearly as bulky as it is. Because if you don't know, Sandstorm makes all rock type Pokemon have 1.5 times extra special defense. Cradily being a rock type Pokemon, its special defense goes through the roof for that Sandstorm's up. I'm just hitting up with Lavaplume. He's gonna hit me out of the Miracle. I'm like, okay, that's fine, because the Miracle's gonna break the substitute. I can just go with another substitute the next turn. Sandstorm fades. So I'm all hunky dory right now. I'm looking really clean, because he has a burned Cradily against my Heatran. Sandstorm's gone, so he has to rather leave his Cradily in to take a Lavaplume, or he can switch out and do really anything. He goes in with Terrakion. I probably would have went out with a Hippowdon, honestly, myself. But he goes with Terrakion. I can't judge that. I think Terrakion's a pretty good switch, too. But I go with another substitute, so I'm looking nice and clean. I'm hoping he's going to use Close Combat on the substitute, because that way his defense will go down and he can die to one Earth Power. But he goes with the Earthquake. So I'm like, you know what? Earthquake, that's chill. You can take on my substitute. I'm still going to hit you with a nice Timid Max Special Attack Earth Power. He reveals his Life Door, so he does 10% HP to himself. Now eat this Earth Power, bitch! And he lives with like 9%. Like he's gonna die to the next Life Orb damage. He is so low, he's gonna die to the next Life Orb. I'm happy with that. So I'm like, Duga, come back. You don't get the reference? Go watch anime. Read HP Lovecraft. Either way, Archer comes back out. Archer coming out Death Fodder. Archer did his job. Took out Hydreigon. Took out Volcarona. And now that Archer goes down, Archer is taking Terrakion with him because of that Life Orb. So Archer, this is your debut Wi-Fi battle in Carol Studio, and you took out half the opponent's team. I could not ask for more. Thank you, Archer, for being on this team. Either way, Aerodactyl comes out. Fuzz McBuzz is looking clean, because Fuzz McBuzz hasn't been on the channel for a longer time. Fuzz McBuzz is that type of girl who she's just like, you can have your, like, fossilized Mega Pterodactyls coming at me, but I'm just, Fuzz McBuzz is just that kind of girl who just doesn't give a shit. Aerodactyl goes for the Protect. Fuzz McBuzz just sitting there like, you know what, you go for the Protect. You do all the things you need. I'm going to Volt Switch on you. Either way, Aerodactyl's going to go with the Rock Slide now that Protect has happened, so I couldn't even Volt Switch. Rock Slide's always going to take me down to my Focus Sash. I'm always a Focus Sash Fuzz McBuzz, because why wouldn't Fuzz McBuzz be Focus Sash? Fuzz McBuzz does not get flinched. Fuzz McBuzz hits her Thunder. That's a dead Aerodactyl. Like, it's not going to survive. It's not going to survive a freaking Thunder from Fuzz McBuzz. Buzz McFuzz. Fuzz McBuzz. Buzz McFuzz. Oh my. Either way, Hippowdon comes back out. I know what I need to do to this Hippowdon. Fuzz McBuzz. I want to keep Fuzz McBuzz alive, because you know what? If I can get rid of the Sandstorm, Fuzz McBuzz can do a nice Bug Bust to that Cradily. Going with Arwing, my Skarmory. I don't think Skarmory's been on this channel before either, but I've had Skarmory for months, nearly a year now. It's going to hit me out of the side. So you're wondering why I'm going for the spikes when there's only two Pokemon left, is because that Cradily, if it survives, it can recover and recover, and the rest of my team can't do anything against recovering Cradily. So now I'm going to talk to the Hippowdon, put a timer on that Hippowdon. Hippowdon's going to go with the Crunch. Nom 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 nom. Thing is, you can't eat an Arwing. Starfog, Starwolf, Starfalco, they'd all be pissed off if you try to eat their Arwings. So anyway, Arwing's going to hit you in the more spikes. Just lay all those hazards. Lay all hazards, because Cradily does not want to come in on Stealth Rocks plus 3 layers of spikes is the thing. It really does not. Nothing wants to come in on 3 layers of spikes and freaking Stealth Rocks. That's so much damage. That's just, ooh, that hurts. Because 3 layers of spikes is 25%. Stealth Rocks is going to be like, I think, like 6-8% or something like that. I don't know. I don't know how much Stealth Rocks is normally. Either way, crunch me again. I don't care. I'm an Arwing. You can't eat a spaceship. Star Fox rides on Arwings. Star Wolf rides on Arwings. Falco rides in Arwings. I'm an Arwing. Oh my god, that sounds so weird. After a while, Arwing. Either way, you can just keep on crunching my Arwing. It doesn't matter, because, you know, Arwing is so bulky that, you know what? Now that you're down, now the toxic's done so much damage to you, just break it in. Bunch! Right through ya. Critical hit did not matter, because even if the critical hit, even if the Braver didn't take it out, it would have done a toxic damage. So now Cradily comes out. Just look at this. Half health Cradily. Freaking Stealth Rocks. Spikes. Brave Bird. I'm just like, meow. Bitch. And that's dead Cradily. So that ends the game with me, 3-0 victory. I'm just happy with the spell. I just wanted to have the spell just because of how much work Slurpuff did. So either way, nice job, Slurpuff. Question of the day. What is your favorite fairy type Pokemon? My favorite fairy type is easily Azumarill. Azumarill, Bleezus. I don't know what you want to call it. I call it Bleezus. I love Bleezus. I have a Bleezus shirt. I love Azumarill so much. I keep saying Arnx. You said it so much. Freaking Slurpuff is definitely my second favorite fairy type Pokemon. But what's your favorite type fairy type Pokemon? I know a lot of you are going to say Gardevoir, and I hope you guys aren't saying Gardevoir for the perverted reasons. I hope you guys are saying Gardevoir because you like it. Not for perverted things that you see in a Rule 34 or anything like that, because Rule 34 of the internet is Gardevoirs. Do not look up Gardevoir without your safe search on Google, kids. If you want to look up Gardevoir on Google, please make sure you have your safe search on, kids, or you will see some very bad things. Oh, boy! Same thing with Mawile, but more or less Gardevoir. Anyway, I love Azumarill. I love freaking Slurpuff. Who was your favorite fairy type Pokemon? Leave it in the comments. Like, comment, subscribe. Also, tell me if you like the Swinub. I love the Swinub, but tell me if you like the Swinub. Either way, Kirikiro Studio, like those 10 likes. Please hit the like button. We haven't been hitting it a lot lately. And if you have missed Wi-Fi battles lately, please go watch them. Please go watch the 2 free-for-alls on this channel. Leave some feedback on those. Tell me if you like them. Get those at the 10 likes as well. Kirikiro Studio, I'm out.